Just say it again for the recording that I have lost the hope to improve my English, and my English is going to stay my trademark for the rest of this life probably. So what to do? But people usually understand me. So let's start. We are talking today about self-esteem, self-perception, improvement of them, self-image, and all the stuff about our self-identity. Self-identity is a much more scientific concept, of course. That means that we have always image of ourselves, image of our peculiarities and traits of character, of our personal differences, personal specific peculiarities, our uniqueness, and that specific combination of everything gives us a specific feeling of myself. So that is much more realistical and scientifical thing. Meanwhile, self-esteem is, if you think, what is it exactly? You can find that you cannot grasp it. What does that mean, self-esteem? Psychiatrists believe that this concept was invented by psychologists in order to earn more money. I don't know how you will accept this truth, but I somehow agree with that, because when someone says self-esteem, my self-esteem is low, what does that mean? You still being you, you haven't changed. Maybe some of your actions changed, or you did not reasonable actions. So it's about behavior. It's not about you, right? Or you started to think badly about yourself. So you have thinking problem. But esteem, what does that mean? Can anyone explain me, please, in the chat, okay? So what we measure when we judge ourselves and how we prefer to think, more and more you observe it and you can find absolutely another problem. So it's not problems of any self-esteem or scales of that esteem. And yes, if we talk about self-esteem, it is normal that time after time, we doubt our actions, we doubt the righteousness. It's normal part of healthy, critically thinking mind. You understand what I mean? Without that, we lose ability to be objective in thinking, not only subjective. Subjective means that I presume so, but it doesn't mean it's true. I think more and more very internally, leaning on my internal truth, on my visions and perceptions, not on objective facts, what does really exist in reality. So when we start to think that I'm always right, or whatever I do is right, yes, it's a nice concept, but again, what is right, what is wrong? In this situation, from that perspective, it was right. After a couple of days, you will reassess it, you will find it, you will find a mistake in it. You see? So when we talk about particular, very exact cases, it is never an issue of self-esteem. It is something else. Give me examples, please, when you were dealing exactly with self-esteem for us to see what was really there. Mm-hmm. Because I want to grasp all together with you. I want to grasp this self-esteem, this non-existent abstract concept, somebody's conception, which were imposed to society, imposed to us. And we started to think about self-esteem. You can estimate or assess my appearance, my behavior, the way how I give you this material. You can assess my skills or my communicative forms, how I'm trying to give you the message. But you are assessing them. How can it be related to my self-esteem? I'm also assessing them, and I have something with what I'm quite satisfied and something not satisfied. Aha, examples are coming. In performance situations, you mean when you start to criticize the way of your movements or the way of your, how you perform the presentation, right? It's about skills again. You want better skills or you want to like the way how you did it. Right? You are criticizing what? If you are criticizing even your abilities, it is still abilities and skills next to those abilities to be developed. Don't confuse those things. Your value is still the same as your nature, as personality, as human being, the way you are. It's still not less, not more. Because the main idea which I'm going to tell you today about that is that we didn't invent ourselves. Our mind can try to assess what we already have from so many different perspectives. It depends what you measure and using what, with what you are trying to assess, with whom you are comparing me, right? With whom you're comparing hibiscus again? With rose or with another flower, with frangipani? But initially, the hibiscus is hibiscus. No matter how many and how much, how many times and how we will criticize or assess or estimate, measure it, the value of hibiscus is constant. It's just hibiscus and all other things around it, the aroma, the movement, the attraction for this bee or for that bee will be different. Please give me more unpacked story about performance situations. Uh-huh. What exactly is a self-esteem issue in your opinion? I have low self-esteem because I don't think of myself in a positive light. So that's self-esteem issues, right? It's issues about your thinking about yourself. Something wrong with your thinking and concepts about yourself. And that I conception or self-identity. When we start to see it in more details, what exactly wrong with me? What do I hate in myself? You more and more came to understanding that you just do not accept your own nature or parts of it, or you just don't like some behaviors or choices of yours. And maybe it's reasonable. Maybe you are very right that you don't like that you fighting with the neighbor. Maybe you just hate this trait, this phenomena of fighting. So you don't like it in yourself when you perform it, when you do that. You see, you distinguish again yourself, your value, and your conception about yourself, because behaviors and phenomena which you try time after time, they are changeable. In performance situation, It's like I can feel that my abilities may not be adequate. And another layer on top of it is that it lowers my self-esteem further, because it's like, why can't I be someone who is so confident in this? You want to look confident, right? Because while you are dancing, you are already quite confident in what you do. When you are in process already, you are confident. But you want maybe better skills in some particular ways, and you want to look confident, because to feel confident is another issue for psychiatrists. It doesn't exist either, even though it sounds like total crazy thing. When you are doing something and you are in process fully, you are already confident. You feel confident, you even don't think about, am I confident or not? But to look confident is another thing. We want to look confident. Why? Because we have some purposes, some goals. And to look confident is a very well-developing skill. It's just a matter of some training. Play that you are confident. Try to play that role as an actress. That role in a movie which you would like to play. You remember the proverb, fake it until you make it. You need to pretend you are totally confident until you will start to feel at ease. Why can't I be someone who is so confident in this? And you have your own way of look confident, right? You have your own image of confident Samantha, because confident Sally has her own peculiarities in that assertive manner of doing something, charismatic, charming. But it's interesting because it's situation specific, not all performance situations. Some, when you feel how, you can see what affects your state once you're performing not that way you usually enjoy. Whatever we perform is very close to joy. More you are enjoying what you're doing, the process itself, more you are confident, and you have no time even to think about self-esteem or whatever. Unusual things I'm telling you, right? Because usually psychologists start to talk about all those scales of how good I am and so on. That's the point, that it's not something which is going to be stable once and forever. I'm good. What means I'm good? I'm not good or bad, I'm just human being. Today I can like what I do. Tomorrow I don't like it. It's normal. For this person, I am good today. For that person, not really. For some person, I'm always bad, unconditionally. Just because they don't like my face or whatever, I don't know. They don't like I'm white, or they don't like I'm whatever. What do you think about imposter syndrome? It is typical for anxious people, especially when you are currently. It's very typical for some specific types of personalities, yeah, I would say. Not all people can have imposter syndrome, but when you use your critical normal thinking and you understand it, in this situation, it's much more reasonable to be an imposter, because it doesn't affect anyone's interest. It is improving my situation. It is only really for the best, realistically. Then it's not a bad thing, absolutely. Imposter syndrome, what is that? It is a that specific fear. Correct me if I'm wrong. That specific fear that I am doing something fake, that I'm an imposter. Let's say it's becoming very acute when we start to make an important presentation in front of a lot of people, and we suddenly feel that, oh my God, I don't know anything. I am not good at that. Absolutely, who I am to be here. Imposter phenomena, impostorism, fraud syndrome, or the imposter experience is a psychological pattern in which an individual doubts their skills. I would say extremely doubt when you are just, oh my God, I don't know anything. Like with your exams, Amaria, recently. If you had such specific acute fear that you are going to fail, even though you knew you were learning hard and you are not an imposter, but that specific acute fear, like, no, it's not me, I cannot, it's a fraud from my side. How can I pretend I know anything, or I'm a good specialist in this, or whatever. Extreme self-pressure, self-doubt about your skills, talents or accomplishments, and has a persistent internalized fear of being exposed as a fraud. Yes, they are going to reveal it soon. They will now understand that I don't know anything, or that I'm not good in that I didn't learn anything, that I was just pretending or whatever. So again, phenomena of imposter syndrome is very separate thing. It depends on what situation it comes. Usually, of course, it happens with people who are not imposters. It is typical for people who are really good in something. That's the pity statistics. People who do not doubt themselves, like almost absolutely in the field or in something, that's a much bigger concern. So it is good sooner or later to have times of imposter syndrome. In the beginning, usually in the beginning of your professional career, or when you are young with your exams, in some specific first in life situations. Так, we continue. So, ladies, what I wanted to tell you about self-identity. Self-identity is the thing which was formed during mostly, was not formed, but I would say was ultimately completed at the late teenage. And after 16, our personality perception is supposed to be, I'm going to surprise you, quite rigid, when we should not doubt our value and our authentic personality, authentic nature, and the value of it anymore for the rest of our life. We can doubt skills, behaviors, choices, reasonable, not reasonable, right or not right, for that situation. But our own value, nature, our who am I, we should not normally doubt after 16 years old. And of course, such a healthy case is very, very rare case in our societies. What do you think about it? Tell me. Self-identity will change little bit. Let's say we will find time after time during our life that figure of ideal someone which we would like to apply on ourselves. Like whom I was admiring at 14 years old and whom I was admiring at 25, they are different figures, right? So it is normal to change that kind of perfect picture of someone time after time. Normally, if development goes quite well, every 5 years, you need to change that ideal picture of someone on whom you would like to be, who you want to be like, you understand? With this, I need to give you a practical exercise. You need to accomplish it. I don't know if you did it before ever in your life, but even if you did, it's never bad to repeat it again. Mm-hmm. Maybe you've heard about it. It's called Persona and Shadow. And the author is Carl Gustav Jung. Maybe you remember about the guy. One of the brightest scientists and discoverers in a deep psychology. Aha, please don't Google it, because the way how I will give you this and the way how you will Google it, it can be a bit controversial, because I'm giving you psychotherapeutical version. Persona and shadow. What I will need you to do, take a A4 list and make three columns there. Aha, I will show you now. Three columns like that. Aha, persona and shadow. Three columns like that. The first column will be persona. Just write persona. The second column will be shadow. The third one I will explain you later. So in persona, you will need to write down the next thing. Imagine on another planet a wonderful woman. If you are a woman, you imagine a woman. If you are a man, you imagine a man. In whom you admire everything. You're literally in love with that person, with that personality. The way she looks, the way she moves, the way she organizes things, the way she communicates with other people. Her appearance, her everything, her charisma, her intelligence. Write down all those peculiarities which you really like in her. Why do you like her? Mm-hmm. Imagine that you were watching, observing her life from a side for quite some time, and you found out that you really admire, respect, and love everything in that. So this lady or man will be called persona, and you write down everything what you like in her, mm-hmm, or in him. Again, for ladies, it's supposed to be her. For men, it's supposed to be him. In the next column, you will describe another person. On the same planet, not knowing each other, another person exists. Seems like everything what you can find in this lady, or man, if you are a man, is disgusting. You really don't like, you are puzzled how someone can be like that. You hate it, you have very negative reaction, but not because someone says, let's say this person is not neat, and you just know that it's not good to be not neat, but personally it doesn't bother you. We don't need this example, okay? Something what personally touches you, makes you feel so frustrated and disappointed about this person, about this personality. So this second woman or man will be shadow. Again, remember, if you are a woman, both of them supposed to be women. If you are a man, both of them supposed to be men. I need details here, details, okay? And on our Saturday's session, we are going to continue with that. What do you think? Or you want me to give you all the descriptions now? Let me know. Uh-huh. So meanwhile, you can even start now. Listen to me and start to do the task, okay? Whatever comes to your mind. Uh-huh. I will give today. Uh-huh. Just I need you just to accomplish some of it now without my explanation. Uh-huh. It's better to do this way. And then after we will already do the next one. Так. Concept of self-esteem is fake. That's what I need to tell you today. Whatever you call self-esteem, you can convert. You dig deeper and you see that it's not about non-existent self-esteem. It's about something very concrete and realistic, okay? And don't make yourself fooled with that. Self-identity is on whom I want to be look like or with whom I'm associating myself. I'm associating myself with white young woman, Eastern Siberian one, but semi-Sisilois already. I'm, by the way, truly identifying already. I can feel, I can see it, how my self-identity is not the same, absolutely, like several years ago. I don't feel myself fully only Russian. And I don't feel myself fully Seychellois. I feel cosmopolitan and mixture of both in the same time. Difficult to describe, but that's a specific feeling and it's a comfortable feeling. Whenever you assess your own value in a correct way, it is always a comfortable feeling. You just accept something what you did not invented, what you did not create, it was given already with all the genetics, with all epigenetics, the way of upbringing, the way of absorbing things. There are literally clusters in your brain, clusters of chunks of information and conceptions, which you interiorized. You have taken it as yours. You have made it your belonging, part of your thinking styles, part of your perception and understanding of this world, part of your vision. But you need to be able to distinguish that they were imposed. You have taken it, absorbed it with another things during your upbringing, during all your life history, but they do not belong to you either. You have taken conceptions and way of thinking, beliefs, conceptions, concepts, beliefs, clusters of information, understandings of world and phenomena, even this knowledge which I am now broadcasting, you are also taking and you decide where to put it, what to digest, what not, what to use. I hope you will use it. You will be brave enough to just to use it. But since the very early childhood, everything was inserted, imposed by society, by parents, environment. Since all your sensations of your body were informing you about this world and your brain made constantly kind of a conclusions about what is this world about and how to survive in here. This is also you. You see, it's so difficult to distinguish things which are not you in the same time they are fulfilling you since your very early childhood. But still you are you without them. Something without all the recorded things in your history. You need to be able always to have a gap between innocent, pure you and all the conceptions, beliefs, and content of brain, informational content, which you have eaten and digested and decided to. I decide this become mine. Okay, now it's my belief too. But initially, it was not yours, and you need to realize it. You've taken it, and you've decided what to do with that. Aha, you still haven't told us how to improve your self-image, though. So, self-image. Image of yourself. Do you have only one? I believe that something particular is there as a problem. Because your image normally supposes to be already improved, as I've told you, before 16 years old. This is already ultimate version of who I am and everything is fine with me. All other things are not me, my skills, my behaviors and everything. So what exactly supposed to be improved in my image? Good question. You need to write it down because this is very blurry. It's a trap to think that I will do something and my self-image, my opinion about myself will be so great. You don't like or you don't accept something particular, which is also imposed belief. Someone suggested, someone imposed it to you that this is disgusting. What exactly? If it's a really disgusting behavior, harmful to others, then yes. And you need to work on that behavior and reactions. Only this, but it's not about you. Your nature is, you were born like that. You already have all your genetics. You need to embrace your initial self-image. The way you are is innocent. But where problems come from? Or you think, you believe you are not good enough. You need to be, let's say, beautiful like that person or wonderful or smart like that person. This is already delusional content. You cannot be them and you will never be. You can pretend or play and always feeling frustrated that you are not them. That's the initial problem, that you do not accept unconditionally the way you are, just because you still believe that your nature is supposed to be changed somehow, formatted. You remember the caterpillar story? When she was broken and when she recovered back, what did she do? She gave up to her own nature. She realized that her body has its own movements, which she cannot really even take under control that much, like she believed before. Before she believed in total control, that she can change her own nature and everything, which was a total bullshit. It's a crazy idea even to start to think that way, to interfere in your nature, which were already given and created initially the perfect way. What if it was already invented the perfect way and you are now trying to argue with that? So I want you to understand only, to accept your way of what is already there and not doing anything with that. This is one thing you will have to achieve. And to distinguish what you really hate and you don't like. What's supposed to be really improved. like my skills in doing online sessions supposed to be improved? In what way? Who decide, right? I will never achieve something perfect. There will be always people who will say, no. You are doing it in not that really improved way. So, you know, perfectionism. Perfectionism is a very toxic, harmful, artificial substance. It's a mixture of anxiety and obsessive thoughts, obsessive image, that obsessive ideas that there is a high standard which does exist and I will achieve it soon. The highest standard on a horizon. You know the good thing with horizon. Horizon is never achievable. Horizon will always stay there. Even if you are moving very fast to that horizon, it will also move in fast from you. The same with perfectionism. What you are trying to achieve in improving your self-image, what exactly, that's very important to understand. In details. Start from identifying very honestly, what do you hate? What do you don't like in yourself? Mm-hmm. And sooner or later, we both will find out that it's problem in you, with you, your problem. But initially, it also came, epigenetically came from outside to you. It was the best way to cope with this life. It was the best way to survive at some time ago. But now it is not working anymore. And now it even scares you. And it looks disgusting. But your coping mechanism hold it still as one of the best ways to deal with this specific problems or specific people with specific stressors. And you hate that image of yours who is holding that type of coping mechanism then, but not yourself, right? So once you identify what exactly is failed there or not working anymore, need to be changed, then you will see that it's again, self-image is nothing. It's only you and the way how you enjoy your life and you survive and you look for yourself doing things the way you like. Another thing is social approval, of course. Yeah, I understand. It's one of our very important needs, social approval. We need, life teaches us to be so wise with that because it's so easy to be tempted. I want to be approved by almost everyone. I want everyone like me, which is already irrealistical expectation, right? We are going to be very disappointed because in realistical life, it's not achievable. Self-image means self, not my image for that person or for that. You need to like yourself. Identify what is the problem you have with that. What exactly is not really beautiful or nice? Everyone is not meeting your own standards. Uh-huh. We need to explore your standards. Your standards need to be found during some time. Like for Mr. Paul, standards of Mr. Ted, not applicable. But Mr. Paul likes those standards, so he has taken them too. Seems like he has taken Mr. Tom's standards, Ted's standards, Because they are so realistically achievable and they are so nice, reasonable, and so on. But he didn't really found his real own standards. Like, it's normal for me to require this within this time, and I'm feeling good because I will accomplish everything with a good quality, with a nice time, not raping myself, not losing energy, but gaining energy. That's your standards. But if you take somebody's standards on you, you are going to have problems with anxiety, procrastination, definitely. Inner perfectionist will always poke you that you are not good enough still. Standards are there, and where you are, stupid someone. It's only sign if you are, according to your standards, are not still very good doing something, it's not your standards most probably. You need to find honestly out your standards. And again, let me just describe you how you will find your own standards. Only practically finding out how you are coping with things which are really important, with things which are really important for you. And everything what you are doing to achieve them is so comfortable for you, or it's not overstressing you all the time. This is your standards. Because for one person to write the thesis within 3 months, it's her standard, and she's coping, and quality of thesis is good, and she's sleeping well, eating well, she's maintaining her health. That's a normal standard for her. But for someone, they also would like to achieve it in 3 months, and they say, yes, those standards are so good, and they cannot do that because they need it either faster. They cannot lie on the beach without doing anything. They feel more anxious. There are some people like that. Or they need 6 months to accomplish with the same-ish quality and quantity body of the thesis. They need 6 months. But how to find it out? Only learning the way how you do things with comfortable states. If you are coping well and you are productive, record your new standard. That's your standard. You will be always in peace with your standards and no issues with self-esteem. You can even defend your own standards in front of other people. Like, for me, it is normal to do it this way because I'm coping and I'm even enjoying life. Yes, university will dictate you their own standards, and then you just adjust according to your nature, knowing yourself, how to meet your own expectations, how to satisfy your needs, feeling always good and accomplishing uni standards. I forgot to congratulate you, my dear ladies and gentlemen, Seishowa, with a new president of the country. I'm quite skeptic when it comes to politicians, but I have to admit I'm also full of hope, of course, for the country. So we'll see how things will go soon. Talk. Self-perception also, it's something. The way how you perceive your place in this world and you in it. Self-perception dictated a lot by previous experiences. The way how I see myself also is a summary of how I was seeing myself all the time. It is changeable though. In case of serious mental disorders, self-conception is affected very seriously. Conception of myself. And psychotherapy is prescribed for the rest of the life more. Let's say with personality disorders. In most of cases, it's not correctable. Issues with self-conception. Because it's determined also by pathological conditions of brain. Brain is not able to maintain quite stable self-conception and self-perception along with normal thinking. Brain is not able to hold it. So that's why everything suffers, of course. Aha. So this task, actually, if you have accomplished now already, what you will need to do is to convert everything what contains in shadow. You need to convert each trait into hidden power or hidden positive intention or hidden possibility. I will give you an example. If in your shadow you write down, she's lazy. In this column, you need to put an arrow and put another side of laziness, a good side. Mm-hmm. Like she is able to be meditative, or she knows how to relax, or she is careless. She is not affected by any, I don't know what you can find. Another example can be she has anger issues. She is very explosive, outbursting person. What can be even in this a good positive side? In what situations? It's a golden trait. It's a wonderful trait. Yes, right. She can be assertive. She can be self-confident, or she is able to protect, to defend herself. That's what aggression is about, right? And anger. After converting each of negative trait into a positive one, when you find out the hidden good side of it, helpful, powerful one, then you can see that both of them are parts of your self-conception, current one. The persona one is that side of your personality which you prefer to show to this society in order to survive better in society. So whatever is written in persona, it's still you. It's part of your nature. It's your traits, maybe underdeveloped or developed enough already. But it is you. But this is that side which you prefer to show off more. Like, look how this I am. If you write down, she's kind and I don't know. Also, you need to describe what exactly in that kindness you really admire in her. The very zest of her kindness, because everyone would definitely write in the goddess part, this is kind of a goddess, right? Or god. Everyone would write kind, intelligent, smart, trustworthy, amazingly communicating, charismatic. It's too general. You need to define more in details what is really admirable there. What are those wonderful traits? And believe me, this is your trait. This is part of you. This is part of your ideal image of yourself and yet part of your nature. It's already included there. And shadow, it's also your traits which you hate in yourself, or you are in denial with, or you are afraid to even to look at them because you feel ashamed, you feel scared, you feel helpless to deal with them. You prefer to suppress, to do not see such traits of yours, instead of just seeing the hidden power of them, why they're there, because they're serving you. It's not a coincidence that you have this list of shadow traits. And this hidden power, it's a hidden energy of your personality, hidden traits, hidden possibilities. You need to embrace them and start to use them in a socially right way. You understand? It's just about how you use such peculiarities of yours. You can convert anger issues into assertiveness and proper ways, socially appropriate ways of defending yourself. All of them are convertible in a positive trait, believe me. If you cannot do that, you just didn't really work properly on the task. I can help you if you wish. We can contact each other. So what we do, the ultimate step, we need to combine, to unite persona and this decoded shadow traits. Combine them in one unique description of yourself, of your nature. You can just literally feel them both inside you, how they are not controversial and they are totally okay with each other, living together in you, and embrace this wonderful nature of yours. You can see that you're quite satisfied with the way you are. There are only things to work on, improving your behaviors, skills, actions, communicative patterns, phenomena which are around you. It's phenomena around you. It's not you what's supposed to be improved. Your nature and your traits are quite okay. And they're supposed not to be there or there. You remember we are all leaves, similar leaves on the same tree, trying to compare each other and trying to find who is better, who is worse. That comparing part of mind in a perfectionist or in a critic supposed to be under your control also. Mm-hmm. So, Miss Amma, I believe you have a lot of work to do since today. Please write down all those things which we discuss, and if you wish, we can have just a session on that, because it's definitely something very concrete to work on. Whenever it comes to confused sexuality, sexual identity, it is just additional problem, of course, for self-image and self-perception. Not because you are confused who you are or what. No, because of social, 90%, it's because of social reactions to that. So to deal with social reactions, that's then the problem. It's not about self-esteem again anymore, my dear people. So can we finish for today, please? And do you like our next topic? I like it a lot. We never talk about sexuality and sexual satisfaction in relationships and marriages. The topic is about, will be about relationships and marriages, not promiscuity or something, any sexual behavior, chaotic one or disposal one. Okay, so I'll be waiting for your feedbacks. Again, congratulations with big changes, hopefully realistical, positive changes in our beloved Seychelles. Thank you too. And see you this Saturday at 1 o'clock. Maybe for the last time. We'll see. I will see how many participants will join the club before this Sunday. We'll see. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much. And have a good evening. Bye-bye.